this is gonna be a reaction video. A reaction, yeah, reaction video. Is there a mark on it? Okay, no, it's a bone. Okay, all good. My name is Monique. This is obviously not the cauldron. This is my living room. And this weekend, we are going to do a little reaction reading vlog to this baby. Yeah. In case you were not aware, this is Bookwitch Reviews, where I do things such as reread my favorites, even though I have a ton of arcs that I need to read, because Harrow the Ninth came out on the 4th. It's the sequel. This is the first one. I adore Gideon. I wasn't on BookTube when I read Gideon. I could not explain the pure immense joy that I had from reading this book. So we're gonna do it now. You're welcome to reaction vlog. Hooray. I have only ever done one other reaction vlog, and it was to Crescent City for a Sarah J Maas. And I don't know how this is going to go, but we are going to try our best. I don't know how long it's going to be. I don't know really what I'm going to talk about. I may or may not be spoilery. The title will say so. But, you know, I'm just going to start because I have desperately wanted to have a reread. And I'm going to do it because I'm an adult and I make my own choices. Also, gin. So, let's do it, team. So we are a chapter in, and I remember what took me by the throat the last time I read this book. Obviously, it's science-y and bonesy, but it's also full of humor and dirty magazines. And I'm just like, I just love her so much. You know, it's a wonderful book. And I knew it when I read it the first time, when the main character says, "Go suck a dick to make someone go away." Oh my God, that's what I say to people when I really, really don't want them to talk to me. Very own Gideon update now with neon tabs. Do I really know how to tab? No. Am I just tapping for the heck of it? Absolutely. This bringing me a lot of joy to read this again though. So here are some of my thoughts already. Obviously it's still really technical. I'm on chapter 14 and Gideon has literally just, this is where like our like mystery part of becoming a lictor comes in, and Gideon has literally just said, "Its hands looks a little bit like swords, so I want to fight it." Which is literally just the embodiment of Gideon, who's also a very tall, six-pack, buff lesbian with red hair wearing skeleton makeup. And I'm I love it so much. Also, I really like the effect this is like having of like tabs on black, but I will be buying the paperback edition. One, because there's extra material in it, and two, because then I might move my tabs from my lovely black edition over into my paperback. But yes, having just a lovely time rereading this. I'm just having such a nice time. So it is still Saturday. I finished my shift downstairs, which was a good fun as always, and I did some more reading. I'm still tapping away because this is apparently who I am. Also, I really like the way that this looks. Anyway, basically, it's really hot in the UK, which is why I'm sitting in my bra in my, well, it's like a bralette or whatever, so we don't care about it. But so I'm running out of yellow tabs, which are like my ones for like funny stuff, which there is a lot of because Gideon is funny as hell. So purple is now the funny tab. But also we've gone into the murder mystery part of the book, and the bit where Harrow is telling Gideon that they have to work together and like, how can I become someone you trust? And I'm like, Gideon, you're not prepared. And also, I've never prepared for Magnus Quinn and his necromancer dying, and I'm just like, oh my god. And I know what's coming next, and I'm not ready. There's a Mean Girls joke in here. I just love Camilla Hecht of the Six so much. I just, yes, so good. Don't you just love a book that makes you chuckle to yourself? Like, you know, like a hack. Just like, nah, funny, my midnight baguette, nah. Sounds like baguette. God, I'm a dad. Babies. I am not prepared. I'm not okay with how kind Gideon is, and I'm not okay with how much Harrow hates herself, and I'm never going to be okay about it. It's just gonna haunt me for the rest of my life. I can't read the next one, it'll hurt me. Hello team, so it's a Sunday night and I started Harrow the Ninth, my little reread this morning. I went to the beach and then I have basically just become one with my couch. And because I'm not super comfortable not like filming without makeup on, actual filming without makeup on, and also because I've literally been so warm that clothes are just like not a thing I can do right now. Obviously we've not had a whole lot of updates today. Obviously Harrow is still absolutely delightful. Gideon hurt me in my soul, and it rereading this is just reminding me how much care and
thought has gone into building these characters and how much care and thought has gone into making this fucking weird for us. So we're tapping again, having a nice tap, still having a really nice time about the fact you can't see it. See it, see it, no, okay. But yes, just Tamsyn Muir can just murder me in her writing and I'll be happy about it. But I'll give you guys more of an update tomorrow, where I'm hoping it's less hot, because I've been sitting in front of our fan all day and I'm still sweating. Obviously, it's still very hot in this life, because as you can see, I have put on eyeliner, but actual other makeup will literally just sweat off on my face, so I can't be bothered. So I thought I would give you guys a little update on my continued reading of Harrow the Ninth. And honestly, I love Gideon the Ninth so much, but if I have to be honest, I think Harrow is better in some instances. It is obviously written by the same author and we're using a lot of the same language, which is confusing and bony and stuff, but it's just the way that this is written, it's just so good. I just love it so much. And we are like, Harrow literally just tried to kill one of the other lictors, and I love that bit also, because she literally doesn't sleep for 6 days, and I just love this very intense, like, is she going crazy, is she not going crazy, second person, third person. And obviously you've read the first book and that means that you know that this is not how it happens, but at the same time you want to know how she thinks that it happens. And I remember reading it the first time and being like, oh my god, what is happening? And it's just so good. So good. Okay, so I'm at that point where Harrow is making a new arm for Yante. And I'm like, why are you so oddly sexual? What? Tamsyn Muir, what is that? Why? Why is it bones? Hello team, so it is now Thursday, and as you may notice, my documentation of me reading Harrow the Ninth was a lot less than me reading Gideon, and that was because I obviously read Gideon over the weekend and Harrow I read over the week, where I have been doing other things. But we are done, we have finished, we have done the thing with these two babies, and I'm so excited that I allowed myself to have some time and to just reread some beautiful bone babies. Also, can you tell that tabbing is new to me, and I'm just tapping everything I think is important, which is obviously every other page, because this is a masterpiece. I will stand by the fact that though I adore Gideon with every fiber of my being, I think Harrow is a stronger book by itself. It also has pieces that I thought that they had changed from the arc, and then I went in this morning and I reread the ending and it is the same, and I must have somehow forgotten it. So I have some questions and a lot of thoughts. Obviously, I think I might do a review on the side for both of these, so for Gideon obviously without spoilers, and then for Harrow as spoiler free as possible in the same video. But basically I just adore these with everything. Like, there is no questions asked about sexuality in this book. You are what you are. There is so much intense thought going into it, and so much humor and pop culture references. For God's sakes, there is a fucking llama with hats reference in Harrow about the whole, like, a hunger for thumbs that only thumbs could suffice, and it's fucking hilarious. And there's a dad joke, and just like the daddest of dad jokes, and it's just, it's so good. And it, the Harrow bit, like, I, as much as I adored it, I forgot about some of the, like, alternative scenarios that happen at the end of the book, where, like, obviously she has been reimagining Can House without Gideon, and then all of a sudden it's like, if Harrow had been the cavalier, and if it had been like a snazzy, like, marriage thing, and Gideon might have been like the empress. I'm not entirely sure. Harrow obviously knows something that other people don't know, and I cannot wait for Electo the Ninth. Like, I will murder and kill and die and come back to read that book before its publication. I don't even think she's done writing it yet. Like, I'm hoping, and then I'm really hoping that it's actually coming out in 2021, because otherwise I might cry. But this is an absolute mess of a video. It's also been really messy to fucking edit, but I've done it. I want to share with you some of my feelings, and that of them I obviously have many, especially regarding Gideon. But Harrow is just into Gideon. If you think it's too hard, I have heard that the audiobook is very good for like bringing you in, and I'm just like, I want everyone to read these because I would like everyone to discuss them with me, and then we can all love these stupid bone babies together. And also, how dare you, Tamsyn Muir, kill so many amazing characters in the first book and then not even bring them back because they're still dead, but somehow have them have a massive impact on the second book, and I never get to have them alive again. That's not fair. That hurts me a lot. Okay, but that's it. Thank you so much for watching this very messy video. If you have read Gideon the Ninth or Harrow, let me know down below. Let us scream about bones together. Bones! And then just, we will all be okay. Maybe regarding the last book of this series. And then please hit that thumbs up button if you haven't already. Hit the subscribe button if you would like to, so that you can see other videos coming out from me. They are all pretty much queerish, or I try because I'm the queer one, you know. And then you can click the little bell at the end and it will give you a notification whenever I put up a new video. And then I will see you guys really soon with another video that makes more sense than this reaction reading vlog. But take care of yourself. I'm proud of you. You are doing great. I will see you guys really soon. Goodbye.